This is Windows 11 and this is Kali Linux 2023 running inside Windows 11. Using WSL2 and WSLG, you can run Kali Linux with GUI and sound support on Windows 11. You don't need any VirtualBox or VMware. The WSL2 feature is freely available and built inside Windows 11, which lets you install Linux very easily. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Kali Linux 2023 with desktop environment on Windows 11 using WSL. Make sure to watch the video till to the end. If in case you enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up to make this video visible to more audience. That being said, let's get started. For those who don't know, WSL2 stands for Windows Subsystem for Linux version 2. You can think of it as the Linux environment that has a kernel compiled by Microsoft and optimized for Linux distributions. This way, you can run Ubuntu, Kali, OpenSUSE, and more inside Windows 11 as a part of the application. With the help of WSLG, you can even run Linux GUI applications and desktop environments inside Windows 11. Compared to VirtualBox or VMware, WSL2 is much faster and quicker. Alright, let's start installing Kali Linux 2023 on Windows 11. First and foremost, make sure you are running the latest version of Windows 11. If you are having Windows 10 on your computer, you cannot run GUI, and it's better to update to Windows 11, which is available for free of cost. Also, make sure your computer supports hardware virtualization. It's enabled by default on modern computers. If in case it's disabled, make sure to enable it from BIOS. Now, on your Windows 11 computer, go ahead and open Settings, choose Windows Updater. And if you see any updates, go ahead, download and install them. Once it's done, click on the Start menu and search for Windows PowerShell and choose to run as administrator. You can also use the command prompt if you are familiar with that tool. Inside the PowerShell, type WSL and you can see the information and usability of this command. By default on Windows 11, the WSL command is pre-installed. It's ready to use to set up a Linux environment. Now type WSL space dash dash install and press Enter key to start installing Linux inside Windows 11. This command is going to download and install a WSL2 kernel, GUI support, and the Ubuntu image will be downloaded automatically. Now all these steps will be done with a single command. Once it's done, you need to restart the computer. After rebooting, you would see a command prompt that is busy wrapping up the Linux installation. Alright, now you can see that Ubuntu Linux has been installed successfully. You can go ahead and set up a username and password for Ubuntu. If you notice, Ubuntu is available as an application on Windows 11 and can be accessed from the Start menu. It's time to install Kali Linux 2023. Just go ahead, open the PowerShell and run it as administrator. Inside here, type WSL space dash L space dash V to list out the installed Linux distributions. Now type WSL dash dash list dash dash online to see the available Linux distributions. Here we can see Kali Linux, which is available to install. To do so, type WSL space dash dash install space dash D for the distribution and type the name of the distro. That's it. Now we have successfully installed Kali Linux 2023 on Windows 11. Also, if in case you want to install the full edition of Kali, which includes so many useful tools, simply type this command that is going to perform a full installation. Please make sure you have at least 20 GB of free space left inside your drive before running this command. Now let's play around with basic WSL commands. Type exit to get out of the Linux shell. You can see the prompt has changed. Now we are back to the PowerShell again. To see the list of installed distributions, type WSL space dash dash list. If you notice, Ubuntu is set to be a default distribution. You can change that and set Kali as a default distribution. To do so, type WSL space dash dash set dash default space Kali dash Linux. Now if I type WSL on the command prompt or PowerShell, I can access the Kali terminal very easily. You can exit the Linux shell and go back to the Windows PowerShell. Now to see the running status of Linux distributions, you can type WSL space dash L space dash V. This will show all Linux distributions running in the background. Once you are done working with WSL, you can shut down the lightweight virtual machine by typing WSL space dash dash shutdown. You can learn more about WSL usage by running WSL dash dash help. It's time to show you guys installing a graphical user interface for Kali that can be accessed via tight VNC. Just type WSL to open Kali Linux terminal, or you can run Kali from the start menu. Go ahead and update the repositories of Kali by typing this command. Then type sudo apt install kali-win-kex. This will download the XFCE desktop environment for Kali Linux. It will take some time to finish the installation, so please be patient. Now once it's done, type kex space dash dash win space dash s and press the Enter key to connect to the VNC server. If you see any prompt, allow it and then add a password. For the view-only password, I'm going to type N. And voila, now you can use the graphical user interface of Kali. It runs much better than VirtualBox or VMware. Let me go ahead and open a browser and play a video from YouTube. Now, as you can see, the sound output is working fine. No issues have been encountered. This is how you set up Kali Linux with GUI on Windows 11. What do you guys think about it? Let me know in the comment section down below. Now to exit from VNC server, press F8 on your keyboard to bring up the contextual menu and choose to disconnect from the server. Lastly, I want to show you guys how to run Linux GUI applications on Windows 11. Inside the Kali terminal, I'm going to type this command to install Blender and see how it works. If you notice, this application is available as a part of Windows 11 and can be accessed from the start menu. This is a Linux application running inside Windows 11. The same way you can run some of the Linux GUI applications on Windows 11. And that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching my video. This has been KSK Ryle. I will catch you in the next video. We'll be right back.